Good morning, students. Today we will discuss how we can connect or create a relationship between two tables. So we know that we are using RDBMS, Relational Database Management System. In RDBMS, data is scattered in different tables, and these tables are interlinked. So in case you want to fetch the data from more than one table and then display the data on the screen, so this is how we can connect these two more than one table at a time. Look at here. I create table. Table name is detail. In this, I take row number of integer type, name of character type, and table is created. If I want to see the structure of the table, so this is the structure of the table. Now I entered details, values, row number one, and name. So three records we have added. If I want to show the contents, select star from details. So look at here. But here row number one is in two records. If I want to change that, the way is update details, set roll number equal to 2, where name is equal to Sumit. So now if I see the result, here is data is here. I create another table, result. In this, I take RN, it is of integer type, marks of float type, and create it is of character 1, because grade A, B, or C like this. So table is already created. So I am taking here result 21. Now insert into result values for 1, then marks, then grade. Oh, sorry. It is the result 21. So first record I did. Second record is added. Third record is. Edit. Now I display the data. This is in second table, and in first table, that is details. Let us see. Now, if we want to get the data from two tables, if I am using here selector star star means all the fields from result 21 comma details. So look at here, that is like this. Who will tell what happened? Any student? अभी
हाँ जी सर
बेटा ये रिजल्ट देखो हमारे पास मेन टेबल में रिजल्ट टेबल है सेकंड वन इज डिटेल टेबल बट व्हेन वी आर यूजिंग सिलेक्ट स्टार फ्रॉम रिजल्ट 21 कॉमा डिटेल्स वी आर फेचिंग द डेटा फ्रॉम टू टेबल्स बट माय आउटपुट इज नॉट एज पर माय एक्सपेक्टेशन यस व्हाट व्हाट हैपेंड
सर ऐसे पता नहीं है
यस अवेश
मुझे भी अभी ऐसे कोई आइडिया नहीं
इश्पनीत सर
सर आई थिंक उसने दोनों टेबल मर्ज कर दी हैं सर
मर्ज नहीं किया देखो बेटा देखो
पहले सर पहले सर पहले एक आया टेबल सर उसके बाद दूसरा टेबल आया मतलब पहले सर
नो
मर्ज
नो
की
नो 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 आई एम गिविंग द आंसर इफ वी आर डूइंग लाइक दिस दिस विल बी कॉल्ड कार्टेशियन प्रोडक्ट ठीक है कार्टेशियन प्रोडक्ट कार्टेशियन प्रोडक्ट क्या होता है कि व्हेनेवर वी आर टेकिंग मोर देन वन टेबल वी आर फेचिंग द डेटा फ्रॉम मोर देन वन टेबल द रिजल्टेंट टेबल दिस वन विल बी द कॉलम विल बी द फर्स्ट कॉलम नंबर ऑफ कॉलम इन फर्स्ट टेबल प्लस नंबर ऑफ कॉलम इन सेकेंड टेबल मीन्स हमारे पास फर्स्ट टेबल में थ्री कॉलम्स हैं सेकंड टेबल में टू कॉलम्स हैं इट मीन टोटल फाइव कॉलम्स आएंगे 1 2 3 4 5 तो जो नंबर ऑफ रोज होंगी हियर थ्री रोज इट विल बी थ्री इंटू थ्री रिकॉर्ड्स मल्टीप्लाई हो जाएंगे थ्री इंटू थ्री नाइन रिकॉर्ड्स होंगे काउंट करो आप 1 2 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 अब ये नाइन रिकॉर्ड कैसे बने फर्स्ट रिकॉर्ड मल्टीप्लाई बाय सेकंड रिकॉर्ड क्योंकि इट इज अ कार्टेशियन प्रोडक्ट 198A 1 अमन देखो 198A 1 अमन देन फर्स्ट रिकॉर्ड इज देन सेकंड रिकॉर्ड मल्टीप्लाई बाय फर्स्ट रिकॉर्ड देन मल्टीप्लाई बाय सेकंड रिकॉर्ड 198A 2 सुमित लुक एट हियर 198A 2 सुमित हियर देन 198A third record here 3 Gautam it means 198A 3 Gautam 198A 3 Gautam then second record look at here 278C 278C then 1 Amit 278C 1 Aman 278C 1 Aman means first records are multiplying with each other so that's why result is here Is it clear? Avish, clear hua? Avish?
Yes.
Ishpaneet?
Haan ji, sir.
So this is called Cartesian product. So whenever we are simply opening to getting data from more than one table, it will always give us Cartesian product. Now, if we want to get the data in proper format, what is the solution? The solution is join. Joining means getting the data, but remember one thing, the records will not multiply. It means in same record, suppose I'm taking here roll number one, here 198A, it will fetch the data from the same record in second table, like roll number one here, roll number one here. For this, we need one common field. Field name may be different, but remember one thing, data must be same. So we need a one field that is common in both table. So look at here, I'm doing Cartesian product, it's called join. So this is called join, look at here. This is Cartesian product. आपने बस एक चीज करना है यहाँ पे. You will use where clause. Where clause is used for setting the condition. तो यहाँ पे हमारे पास जो से common field है, that is roll number. But remember one thing, if I am taking here roll number equal to roll number, there will be one error. So tell me what happened? Yes, any student? Yes, hurry up, beta, hurry up. Give the answer. Dhruv. Shitej.
Yes, sir.
Beta, it's me. Why here is this error? We are saying ki roll number one of the first table is equal to roll number one of second table. And what is the problem here? Ishpreet.
Yes, sir.
Now tell me. Why error here? But simply, we are saying roll number is equal to roll number. But remember one thing, roll number RN field is in two tables. It is not recognizing which RN of which table. So here, look at here. If the field name different, then there will be no any issue. But if field names are same, we will have to use the name of table before this. Look at here. Table name is details dot. Here is second one is result 21 dot. Here one I am checking this problem. Wait one minute.
Sure, by any I go.
Yes. Where if I am using where RN equal to RN, simply it is saying there is a the system is doubtful regarding which RN, because RN is in board table. So we are simply doing that. We are giving one information regarding the table. So here is details dot RN. And second one is result 21 dot RN. So look at here. This is equi-join because we are comparing the equality. So equi-join is here. Join means getting the data from two tables but not multiplying. Simply same record in second table, but because we are checking here the equality, that is called equi-join. So look at here, that is here. Now, if I'm saying I want to see only name and marks, so no any issue. But if I'm saying I also want to see roll number, it's a Oh no. Yes. What is the problem here? Quickly give the answer.
Sir, usko doubt ho raha hai kaun sa RN dekhna pehle table ya second table.
Yes, very good beta, very good. So if the field names are common, you will have to give the table name dot field name. We can use in this if they are not common, even then we can use. For example, name is in the first table, we can use here details dot, we can use here. But no, any type of not necessary here ki give the name details dot name. We can give the name because name is only in the details table. So students, concept is clear. Quickly give the response, beta. Aditya.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear, beta?
Yes, sir.
If you have any doubt, so you can discuss with me. Okay, next is now here we are using a very lengthy you can say statement. In place of using a table name, we can use alias name. Alias name is a name given by the user to the table. Look at here, I am using detail as D. It means D will represent detail and result as R. Here, wait, better. Now, here, D dot. And here R. So look at here, alias name. Take a name given by the user to the table. Otherwise, name of the table is details and result 21. But we are giving the name D and R. So if you have any doubt, you can discuss with me. Pavan, any doubt in this? Manvia?
Yes.
Okay, beta. Now, next is okay, students, look at here. If I show the display the structure of a table details, so we have two fields, roll number and name. Fields are also called attributes. Their data types are there. Here is roll number and name. If I want to add new field or I want to modify the field, there is alter command. So with the help of alter command, we can add a new column, delete a column, or we can change the column, modify the column. So the way is alter table details. Then suppose I want to add a new field, new column, add I take address, add address, and then character, then the size of the field. So look at here. New field added. So if I describe the table details, so look at here, added. But remember one thing, if I display the data, so here is null, means I have not inserted any value here in address. And if I want to add the value, what will be the command? Yes, hurry up. Better quickly give the response.
Sir, update.
Yes, update query will be there. Update. Then name of the table is details. Set address equal to, in double quotes, because it is a character type, Jalandhar. It will set Jalandhar in all the records. But if I want to set the Jalandhar in only roll number one, for roll number one, here I will have to use where clause. Where rn equal to one. So if we see the result, look at here. But if I want to modify, suppose look at here, describe table details. Here, the size of address is 10 characters. So more than 10 characters, we can't enter. So if I want to increase the range, remember one thing, we can't decrease, but we can increase. If we want to increase it, this is with the help of modify. But command will be alter table. Then name of the table is details. Modify. Now take, here is address, and I want to increase its size. Suppose I want to take 15. Then character 15. So look at here, the command will be alter table details, modify address, then the data type is character, and the number of character we can enter is 15. So look at here, if I describe the table, size is 15. So this is the concept of a alter command. Next is, in this table we have not set any condition here, any primary key or unique key or not null key. In that case, so look at here, I have set primary key later on. In beginning, I have not set primary key on roll number. So here is no any key here. So whenever after that, I use alter table details, add primary key, in bracket, I take roll number. Now look at here, in roll number, I have set primary key. Look at here, PRI. PRI stands for primary key. So this is the concept how we can add primary key later on. Shitej, clear beta?
Yes, sir.
So note down this command, beta. Note down, alter table details, add primary key in brackets, take rn. in this version, I want to remove the primary key. There is a problem in her version, so I will discuss later on here. So now we alter the table, we updated the table, then there are some conditions, there are some constraints we can set on any table in order to take valid entry, valid input. So we have already discussed here primary key. We know that primary key data will be unique and it will not accept null value. Null value means we are not giving any value. Value entry is compulsory. Second, unique. So in unique constraint, data duplication must not be there. So data is unique. Third one, not null. Here is not null. Not null means you will have to enter the data. This is the condition. So data entry is compulsory. Fourth one is default constraint. Default means that if you are not giving the value to any particular field, automatically it will take default value. Suppose default value in the case of a city, I take the Jalandhar. It means if the user will not provide the data, city automatically will be Jalandhar. Now five, check. So if I want, suppose age of a student must be less than, suppose 18. So we can use check constraint. In check constraint, we will use a check then bracket. We take age less than equal to 18. It means if user will enter age 19 or above, there will be error message. So these are the different features available in any RDBMS. Primary key, unique, not null, default, and